Faith Lutheran Mission Church, the last Sunday of the church year. Next Sunday we start Advent in the new church year. So it's kind of a neat time to get our hearts and minds ready for Advent. And along with that, we're actually going to have a prayer time during our Wednesdays during Advent, starting a week from this Wednesday, from 6:30 to 7:30. Anybody welcome wants to come in, kind of an informal setup. We're going to be up here in the sanctuary, and it's just going to be a prayer time, praying for the church, praying, getting our hearts and minds ready for the coming of our Lord. We celebrate his birth and his second coming at some point, but it's just a time to pray for this church and get our hearts and minds ready, which was what Advent is all about. So that'll be starting a week from this Wednesday, and we'll meet up here from 6:30 to 7:30 and just have some prayer time. Being that it's going to be a new church season, well, we're going to have some new members today as well. New members Sunday. Rhonda and Steve and Jody are going to be a new member. Steve is not here today, but Rhonda and Jody are, and we'll be having them coming up front here in just a little bit. But be sure during the time of our greeting and our time afterwards, there is cake, yes, afterwards, so to celebrate our new members. Just to let you know, for Operation Christmas Child, we had a total of 129 boxes, which is pretty good for the church of our size. Now, to give you perspective of that, the total goal for Eau Claire was only 3,000 boxes. So we did pretty good to start that 3,000. Now, they did end up going beyond their goal of 3,000 boxes. The total was 3,318. I got the email from the Operation Christmas Child Coordinator for Eau Claire. But we put a very healthy amount of boxes towards it just ourselves. So kudos and kudos for you guys for putting the boxes together and or helping with the shipping costs as well. That's just as important, being able to get those boxes to where they need to go. As long as we're on the whole Christmas theme, this Wednesday at 5:30, we're going to be putting all the decorations up here in church, making it look all nice and spiffy for the Christmas season. And Chuck and Kim have graciously offered to help with pizza and brownies to, well, of course, coffee, yeah. And to help us along right after the decorations are done. So this Wednesday at 5:30, meet upstairs and downstairs, and we'll start putting it all together for another season. Okay, I think that's about it for now. Kayla's going to bring us into the presence of the Lord with a prelude. Then after that time, then, we'll go into our new member recognition, and then our first hymn.
Thank you.
Jody and Ronnie. It's showtime. The important part about these two, and Steve included too, is that these people came in wearing aprons. I mean, literally, when they first started coming, they started doing stuff right away. They're still continuing to do stuff, and it's just I'm so proud of you guys for doing, being new members and wanting to just jump in and doing stuff right away. And so we would like to give you, as from our church, gifts, the devotionals that we give, and this one is for you, Rhonda. It's My Utmost for the Highest, which is still my favorite devotional every day that I read every day, and I hope it blesses you as you have blessed our church. Let us pray. We welcome you as members of Faith Lutheran Mission Church and worshiping God, hearing His word, and proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ through word and deed. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, for these new members of our congregation. By your life-giving power, bind us to each other in you, strengthen us for service, support us all of our days, and bring us at length to that day when all your children will be one in you and will be all in all. And we pray this in the holy name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Big applause. Our opening hymn for today is All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. We've been working out of the green hymnal today, number 328. Please rise as you are able.
We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake, forgives us all of our sins. As a called and ordained minister of Lutheran congregations and mission for Christ, and by God's authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Our next hymn is Alleluia, Sing to Jesus. Still in the green hymnal yet, number 158. Just going to do verses 1 through 4.
Alleluia, sing to Jesus. today.
Is that all right?
Okay. Is from the 51st chapter of Isaiah, verses 4 through 6. Listen to me, my people. Hear me, Israel, for my law will be proclaimed, and my justice will become a light to the nations. My mercy and justice are coming soon. My salvation is on the way. My strong arm will bring justice to the nations. All distant lands will look to me and wait in hope for my powerful arm. Look up to the skies above and gaze down on the earth below. For the skies will disappear like smoke, and the earth will wear out like a piece of clothing. The people of the earth will die like flies, but my salvation lasts forever. My righteous rule will never end. Today's psalm is found on page 259 and 260 in the worship book, Psalm 93. I'll read the first verse and you can respond. The Lord is King. He has put on splendid apparel. The Lord has put on his apparel and girded himself with strength.
He has made the whole world so sure that it cannot be moved.
Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting.
The waters have lifted up the Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves.
Mightier than the sound of many waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea, mightier is the Lord who dwells on high.
Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness adorns your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore.
Our second lesson comes from the first chapter of Revelation, verses 4 through 8. Grace and peace to you from the one who is, who always was, and who is still to come, from the sevenfold Spirit before his throne, and from Jesus Christ. He is the faithful witness to these things, the first to rise from the dead, and the ruler of all the kings of the world. All glory to him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by shedding his blood for us. He has made us a kingdom of priests for God his Father. All glory and power to him forever and ever. Amen. Look, he comes with the clouds of heaven, and everyone will see him, even those who pierced him. And all the nations of the world will mourn for him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, says the Lord God. I am the one who is, who always was, and who is still to come, the Almighty One. Here ends the reading of the lessons. Please rise as you are able for the gospel.
Alleluia, Lord, whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark in the 13th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Starting in verse 24. But in those days, after that tribulation, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds and great power and glory. And then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts out its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I say to you that this generation will not pass away until all these things take place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But concerning that day or that hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Be on guard. Keep awake. For you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going away on a journey when he leaves home and puts his servants in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to stay awake. Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come in the evening, or at midnight, or when the cock crows, or in the morning, lest he come suddenly and find you asleep. And what I say to you, I say to all, stay awake. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Watch and wait, our scripture passage tells us. Oh, and we so love to wait, don't we? Especially this time of year. Waiting in line at the stores. Waiting at stoplights because of all the shopping traffic. Waiting for the pastor to finally finish his sermon. Waiting, waiting, waiting. What is it that we're waiting for? I mean, the only reason we wait is because we're expecting something to happen. In our gospel text, the church is told to wait and to watch because something important is about to happen. And Jesus gives us four important points to consider in our scripture passage for today. And the first point is that Jesus left us his house. Jesus says this in verse 34. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his servants in charge. Jesus specifically uses the word home here for a reason. And that word home certainly has a meaning for each of us. However, Jesus is using this word in much more than a reference to a dwelling place. The Greek word used here for the word home is the word oikios, which means not only the dwelling, but everything belonging to and associated with that dwelling. When Jesus ascended into heaven, he gave us the responsibility for caring for his house and the responsibilities associated with it. The reality is, though, that some of God's houses have not been looking too good lately. Unfortunately, the love of God and his holy word has grown cold in the hearts of too many of God's own people. People are coming to places that look good and act good. However, no relationships with God are being strengthened. No souls are being saved. And Holy Spirit power is not being prayed for. And this is because the Word of God isn't loved. And certainly isn't being adhered to. And it hasn't been preached anymore, as it should be. Take a look at Psalm 91, verse 1, which says this. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. The home of God is a dwelling place. And it is a place where God can keep us close to him and where we are safe from the powers of darkness. It is there that we can abide in Almighty God's shadow for his protection and his power. And that's the home Jesus leaves us. Now, the home Jesus leaves for us is also a place of close fellowship. It is a place where we can meet and feel welcomed and be a part of his own body. The Bible reminds us of this promise in the first book of Corinthians, chapter 3, verses 16 through 17. Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him, for God's temple is holy, and you are that temple. Jesus left this world and left us with his house. And we are a part of his house because we are a part of him. We are a part of Jesus' own body, accepted in him by the power of his blood that was shed for us by his sacrifice on the cross. And because of this awesome sacrifice by Jesus, we have become the literal embodiment of his house. And that word house and home encompasses all that Jesus is. His house represents his power, his majesty, his glory, his mercy, and his grace. Jesus left his house in us so that we can invite others into his house, and that the world can see him in and through us. It's the first important point. The second important point that Jesus left for us is his authority. And so let's look again at the first part of verse 34. Jesus says, it's like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his servants in charge. Now that phrase, in charge, comes from the Greek word exousia, which means a designated power and authority. What this means is that whatever authority Jesus had to carry out his mission has now been handed down to those who are responsible for his house. Church, we have the power, the right, and the responsibility to continue to take care of and build God's house. Jesus gives the power and authority, just as he gave his disciples the power and authority when we read in Luke chapter 9, verses 1 through 2. And he called the 12 together and gave them the power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal. The only question then is not whether we have the authority to cast out demons, cure diseases, and to build his house. The only question is whether we will use that authority Jesus has given us. Or will we allow that authority to lie dormant and unused? I don't stand up here preaching by my own authority. I only preach exclusively by the authority of the Word of God. And that we here at Faith Lutheran Mission Church, why we are even a church, is by the authority given to us by our Lord God Almighty. So let's use that authority, that power that has been given to us through His Holy Spirit to take care of and build God's house. It's the second important point. Third important point that Jesus has left for us is that we have work to do. Let's take a look at the middle part of verse 34 from our gospel text for today. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his servants in charge, each with his work. When Jesus was 12 years old, he remained back in Jerusalem while Mary and Joseph had left for home. They had not gone very far when they noticed that Jesus wasn't with them. So they turned around to go and find him. And where did they find him? In his father's house, taking care of his father's business. And Jesus says this in Luke chapter 2, verse 49. And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" Does that sound like the church of today? Are we all about doing our Father's business? Folks, when Jesus left this world, he left his house for you and I to be a part of. And Jesus gave us authority and power to carry on and do even greater works than he did while he walked this earth.
Jesus also has work to do for us, to do for him,
that gives our lives greater meaning and fulfillment, better than anything this world has to offer. So this then brings us to the fourth important point that Jesus left for us. And that is a command to watch out and to be on guard and stay awake. Let's look again at verses 34 through 35. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his servants in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to stay awake. Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come. That phrase, stay awake, comes from the Greek word gregoreo, which means to stay watchful, vigilant, and alert. The word has a military context of a Roman soldier guarding a gate who has to stay on the alert to watch for a returning commanding officer. Now, the same word for us means that we need to be ever vigilant and ready for the return of our commanding officer as well. So here's what all of this comes down to. Jesus left us with his house to build and care for. Jesus left us with the authority to do great and mighty works in his name. Jesus left us with work to do and a duty to serve him and build his kingdom. And finally, Jesus left us with the command to stay alert and watch out. Now, interestingly, even though our scripture passage for today starts in verse 24, Jesus also tells us to watch out three other times in chapter 13. In verses 5 through 6, Jesus tells us, "Watch out that no one deceives you. Many will come in my name, claiming I am he, and will deceive many." Verse 9 says, "You must be on your guard." And verse 23, the verse just before our passage start for today, says, "But be on guard." And what is it we should watch out for? Jesus gives us the answer in verses 21 through 22, just a few verses before our gospel text for today. Let's take a look at that. Jesus says, "And then if anyone says to you, 'Look, here's the Christ,' or 'Look, there he is,' do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will arise and perform signs and wonders to lead astray and to deceive the elect." So we wait. We watch out for false teachings and false prophets. And we watch with a great expectation of the return of Jesus. In a week, we'll be starting Advent. And Advent is a season of waiting. We wait to celebrate the birth of Christ. And we wait to celebrate and remember his first coming. We also wait in anticipation for his second coming, when Jesus will return to the earth and establish peace and justice in his kingdom.
And while we are waiting, we have work to do.
We need to work at taking care of and building the kingdom Jesus has given us responsibility for. One of our grandchildren's favorite game to play is hide and seek. Now, as most of you know, the person who is it would close their eyes and count to 100 so that all the others could hide.
Now, sometimes the person who was it would cheat a little bit, and then you could hear them count. 1, 2, 3, 14, 15, 61, 62, and so on. Then, whoever the person who was it decided the time was up, you would hear them shout out, "Ready or not, here I come." Now, there's four things here that are always certain about this game. First, the person who was it is definitely coming. The second thing is that they were coming when they were ready. The third thing, the person who was it was coming whether you are ready or not. And fourth, and if you were not ready, then you would pay the consequences. Jesus says this in Matthew chapter 25, verses 10 through 13. And while they were going to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was shut. Afterward, the other virgins came also saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered, "Truly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch out, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." Church, we need to watch for the return of Jesus. And while we watch, we need to do the work he has called us to do. And while we watch and work, we need to watch out for everything in this world that would deceive us and cause us to go astray. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we watch and wait in joyful anticipation this Advent for your return. Your return, Lord. And during this time of waiting, we ask for your guidance and strength to carry on the work you have called each of us to do, to take care of the kingdom you have left for us, and that we are responsible for here on this earth. Father God, we give you thanks and praise and glory for the authority which you have empowered all of us with to continue your mission here at Faith Lutheran Mission Church. And it is in the holy name of your Son, Jesus, that we pray. Amen. Amen. Our next hymn, still on the green hymnal yet, number 518, Beautiful Savior.
Beautiful Savior, we have created you.
together the words of our Christian faith. I believe
in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Lord God, as we move into an Advent season time now, Lord, we need to prepare our hearts again for the celebration of your Son coming into this world to save us from our sins, that if we only believe in his sacrifice on the cross, that we have the promise of the forgiveness of our sins and the promise of eternal life with you in heaven. Lord, that's the reason for the season. Help us, Lord, to put away all the other stuff that this world seems to think is important at this time of year, Lord. Let it be about you. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord God, we pray for this nation as we move into a time that we get ready for a new cadre to come into and take charge of the things of this nation, but also at the local level, too. City councils, school boards, Lord. And so, Lord, we need to pray for those leaders now, even before they come into their decision-making capacity. But we need to pray for them now, Lord, that they make their decisions in accordance to your will. Lord, we also promise to pray for those who are in those leadership positions now and making those decisions, that, Lord, that they turn to you for their answers and not to their own needs. Help us, Lord, to stand strong and pray for this nation and its nation's leaders. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray at this time of year for all those soldiers that are fighting for this nation, Lord, that are putting their lives on the line for us and are far away from their families and friends during this Christmas season, Lord. And they're alone, and sometimes they feel like there's no one out there who appreciates them. And so, Lord, put your arms around them. Hold them tight. Surround them with people who are loyal to you, Lord. Help us as a nation to stand by them, even when they're far away. And Lord, especially, we need to stand by them as they return back here, Lord. Keep them safe. Protect them, Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, it's also a time of travel. So Lord, we pray for all those people who are traveling, not only from this congregation, but people that we know and love who are out and about traveling. Protect them, Lord. Keep them safe on their travels. Lord, we especially pray for all those law enforcement personnel who are protecting us and putting their lives on the line for us out on the streets. Protect them, Lord. Keep them safe. Protect any fire department, ambulance personnel, and Lord, even emergency room personnel as they put their lives on the line for us, Lord. Keep them safe and protect them. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for those soldiers who are putting their lives on the front line for your gospel truth. All those missionaries that we support individually and as a congregation, protect them, Lord. Protect them from any kind of human evil. Protect them from any kind of evil of Satan. Protect them on their travels, Lord, and Lord, please provide them with the resources that they need to do those ministries you've called them to. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for our new members who have come to be with us, and we accept them in as not only members of this church, but as members of the body of Christ, which is more important than anything, Lord. Bless them, Lord. And Lord, help us to remember what it means to be a body of Christ. That, Lord, we are given, as members of the body of Christ, the responsibility and the authority and power of taking care of your house, Lord. And your house is not just about this building on 1704 Hosbaum Avenue. It's about your house. Everyone who is involved with that. Help us, Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
If there's anyone who has any prayers that they'd like to make at this time, please go ahead and say them. We pray for all those who may be ill at this time of year. There's a lot of cold, there's a lot of flu out there, Lord, and there's some people who are, who've got something a little more serious. And so, Lord, we're asking you to send your Holy Spirit down and touch all of those people who are on our hearts and minds at this time in need of your healing touch. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord. We commit all for whom we pray, trusting in the mercy of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share that peace of God with one another.
Give us this day our daily bread.
shine his face upon you and give you his everlasting strength and peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Kids, head on down. That's our signal to go down for children. And a continuous signal.
The rest of us children of God, we've got one more hymn to sing. That is Jesus Shall Reign, number 530 in the Green Kingdom.
Love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.